We get this one ready out there, all taped up. We'll shoot that one right where it sits. And we got this other one in here. Got a little bumper quarter panel there. Try to get you guys set up. There's not a lot of light. I gotta fix some lights in here. So today we'll be painting in the dark. So show you the setup. There's the exhaust fan over there. Goes into a 55-gallon bucket of water. Water. Overspray hits the water and floats on top of the water. Got some more supplies in there. We're gonna be using the MS-78. Some 85 reducer there. And we're gonna go with that shop line sealer. And seal them. So I went through on them. And some PS2 matrix base. So we got some grease and wax remover. We're gonna do that. First thing we're gonna do is tape this stuff up. And throw you on a camera or whatever, or on a stand here. And we'll speed tape this joker up. So thank you. Got them both taped up and pretty much ready to go. Gonna throw some sealer down, and then we're gonna go right to some base. So, get you guys set up in here. I don't have a camera stand here, but it can usually get you set up all right. So. See if I remember all the spots.
Anyway, here we go. We're gonna have some base up. So we'll need some reducer. Pick up there. We're in a hurry today. We got the
same day surgery place today, so we got to get that done. I figured I'd go ahead and turn this on and make a video of these two cars. We're using the MSB shop base. It's 1 to 1.5. Probably mix it 1 to 1, a little on the thick side. Because we're covering a bunch of sand here. I always start off with a 1 to 1 mixture on silver, even if it's 1 to 1.5. Sometimes if you get silver a little too thin, it can get really splotchy on you. I like to pour everything out of the can and then pour the reducer in the can and stir it up. That way you get all the little pearl and residual on the bottom of the can here. I know this PS has a lot of pearl in it. Both these cars are the same code, that works out really good for me. Up, ready to go. I'm gonna mix our sealer up, set this off to the side. Sealer's wet on wet, I do believe. I haven't actually read the P sheet on the shop line. It's been a long time since I used it, so we'll save that can. We'll have leftovers. Gray sealer. 4 to 1. 4 to 1 on this. The last time I used it, I wasn't impressed. It was very thin body. And, it's all separated here. I think it's still good to stir it up, see what we got. We'll knock out today, and we got a couple more. Went to the auction last night and bought more cars. So it was a good thing. Yahoo 66 video, man, all this stirring here. Taped up, ready to go. Check these cups. These aren't my cups, so you can't see these.
throw this in the old Develvis. Lay it down. No reducer in that. Thank you. then. Now we're gonna use our gun like I'm giving away there. Like Milkman 1988 one. I don't know if he's checked in yet. This is a pretty decent little gun. Came across these. And they're in the $60 range, you know. It's not a full-blown professional paint gun, but it's pretty decent. And they spray really nice. They spray clear really good, so. I did the candy job on that motorcycle with it. That's what all this red and orange stuff is. So, yeah, it works really well. Whoever gets that gun should be more than happy with it. It comes with its own regulator. I swapped this regulator over to a Develvis one on this one for clearing. So it's got that kind on it. We'll go with some silver base in here. Find my cap to my tender here first. Stir. Like I said, this is 1-to-1. We mixed it, or it's 1-to-1.5. We mixed it 1-to-1. Back on and I can get the lid to fit. Thank you.
flash off a minute and hit it one more time and then clear this stuff and go to the house. So that's it, man. That's mobile style. Got one out there and one here. This place needs to be a little longer. So, a little bit of overspray. Got the air pressure turned up because it's silver. Those guns will lay it on pretty good though if you turn the pressure down. There you go. And a little spot job out there. A little dent. Pulled out with a stud gun and a little Bondo. Painted it to the stripe. So. All right, let me go ahead and throw some more base on these. I'll turn you guys back on for the clear. And I'll try to get these a little more laid out for you. So that one. Now on to this one. Throw some clear down and we'll be done. It's a little dark in here, so. I don't know if you guys are getting this or not. Like I said, I'll try to get the quality of the videos a little better. Give me a little time, figure out where all the good spots are. Put one more wet coat on and be done.
This is a 2-1 clear. Low BOC, coast to coast legal. Flash time between coats, according to the heat sheet. Flash off for a minute.
Give it the 9 minutes that it wants. So I'm gonna hammer it, and car's getting oversprayed a little bit, but detail will get that. I didn't have a bag. Normally I bag them, and normally I don't get this much overspray, but might be time to clean that fan. Sometimes the blade gets a lot of crap on it, and you gotta clean the blades off to get it to pull. Like I said, it goes into a 55-gallon barrel of water, so it pulls a little slower than a normal fan setup, but it does a good job of catching the overspray and not letting it fly all over the lot. So anyway, pretty non-eventful, looks pretty good. We'll come in tomorrow and throw a stripe on this one, and got a rocker panel and a couple bumpers and such to do. So. Plenty of stuff here for sure. So we'll see how we feel in the morning. Should it'll all depend on what we get done tomorrow, I guess. We'll go out here and give it that old touch and see what the paper feels like. We're ready, no stringing. So tacky backy. Go ahead and hit it with the last coat here. Set you guys back on the wall here and let it fly.
can't see anything. Like I said, it's pretty dark. There you go, looks pretty good. The crappy ones always come out good. Never fails. All right, guys, have a good one.